Now here we are to have a look at how to play July from the Year album by myself. It came out under the name of Johnguitars, and it's still available on CD Baby for download. So here we go. July starts with a C major 7th. Now you shouldn't let a big name put you off because it's just a C chord, but you lift your first finger away and get that nice thing. Right, so here we go. July. Now, of course, you can do various repeats during that. In fact, on the tab, you'll see that there are some suggested repeat points in the tune. Now, the first 8 bars go like this. Now, remember, with this style that I'm using my fingers, but you could actually use a plectrum to do this. It's quite plectrum friendly. The secret is to only go across the strings that you really need. So in my second chord, I've got an F chord, but I really only want 3 strings out of it. So I don't continue to do the whole chord, because the higher notes in that would take your attention away from the actual melody line. In any chord, the melody note has to be the top one, and when you've hit that melody note, well, that is where you stop your strum across. So here we go, the first 8 bars. Now the chords in that, C major 7th, well that's just a C with my first finger lifted away. There's a little bit of an F. I'm actually going to hold the whole F, although I'm only playing a fraction of it. I find that easier rather than learning what would really be a new shape. It's easier just to put in the whole chord and stop at the right point. Also, if you happen to overshoot, then it's going to sound better than that is, you know, so not that you're going to overshoot. D minor 7th, well that's like the beginning of an F chord. Now how I do it is I flatten my first finger across the first 2 strings on the first fret, bring in 3rd string, 2nd fret, and then I'm playing it from the 4th or the 5th string. Both will work there, and that's it. Right, the tab shall now appear for the first 8 bars. Pause the video because it's only there for a few seconds and give it a go. Now our next section includes a wonderful leap of faith at one point where I'm going to have to jump up to the, what is it? Well, it's one of those, isn't it? It's the 8th fret. So 3rd, 5th, 7th, 8th, it's going to be that one. Try and remember that. Pause the video and play. Our third section, starting at bar 17. In that, the D minor in bar 18, well, instead of doing it normally as I would that way, I actually want the F note coming in. So that's what I'm doing. If you can see that there. And when I do my run up the fingerboard, I come from the E. Now, in that wee bit that I just played, all I did was I plucked the first string and the fifth string to give me that, which is a nice quick way of doing it. But if you want to put in the whole chord, which is what I've shown in the tab, it's that shape there, which is a very nice chord. And that's a shape that will work on quite a few different places up and down the fingerboard. Obviously it gives you a different chord in each different place, but it's something you can experiment with. So that's giving me my A minor away up here, and my next chord is a D minor 7th, but instead of it being down here, it's in the second position, and that's just a D shape, standard D shape, but I put my two fingers on the 5th fret. D minor 7th and F are very often interchangeable in music, so if you find that it's awkward to do one, you can always try the other and see if you get away with it. Right, so after all that, bars 17 onward, here comes the tab, pause the video and play. Now my last section is really just the first 8 bars plus 2 bars to wind the whole thing up in a nice neat bundle. No surprises there, so pause the video and play. Now the tab for the whole piece will appear. Thanks again for watching the video.